Hi guys, my name is Stephanie and today we're going to be tasting and testing my 2-year-old water supply. To be exact, this water supply, I bottled it about 2 years and 2 months ago, and I made another video showing exactly the steps I followed to make sure that this water supply would be safe for long-term storage. So check that video out if you want tips for storing emergency water. But for now, I'm going to be pouring some of this water into that pitcher, and we're going to test this water first, just to make sure there's no bacteria growth and that the water is safe for drinking and cooking, washing, whatever. One of the things that I went over in the last video was about why I use these larger, thicker plastic containers for storing my water. And a few people commented on my video with something I actually didn't know, and that is when you store plastic on concrete, that is creating some sort of electromagnetic static between the plastic and the concrete that will eventually break down the plastic and create those little pinpoint holes that we all get in our water storage sometimes. So to prevent that, put an old towel or some cardboard between your plastic storage containers and your concrete floors, or probably even your tiles, just to be on the safe side. It'll prevent leaks in those plastic containers for a lot longer. So I decided that the first thing I wanted to do was to test the drinking water and compare my well water, the water that's straight from my tap, to that emergency water storage. I found this testing kit on Amazon. It tests 19 different things in my drinking water, but I'm primarily more worried about whether or not bacteria was able to grow in this container, if I actually prepared the container well enough so that there was no bacteria in it and the water supply stayed safe for this whole time. So most of the drinking water testing kits don't have that bacteria part, so make sure you look for one that has bacteria as one of the tests. I'll put a link to this one in the description of the video just in case. This kit comes with 2 bacteria testing kits, so I'm going to test my well water and I'm also going to test my long-term water storage. This testing kit is really easy to use, but that bacteria test takes 2 days, so 48 full hours for the bacteria to develop. So I'm just going to run the test on the water today, and then after 2 days, I'm going to show you the results of the test, and then we'll do the taste testing part of this. I'm marking this kit so that I remember that this one is my well water. It's not the emergency water storage. The next bag is going to be the emergency water storage. You only need a little bit of water for this kit, really, so I keep over pouring that water. But that's all right. You can always pour just a little bit out to try to get it to the level that you need it. Once I had that right, I set those 2 tests aside and I moved on to the other tests. So the other tests are just about water quality, but I wanted to see if anything was changed by storing that water for 2 years, how it compared to my regular water. This first test is testing for things like lead, iron, copper in the water. So it's a simple test. You just dip these strips in the water and it develops really quickly, and then we can compare the results. It's sort of like testing your pool water if you happen to have a pool. I think this test ran for just about 30 seconds before it's fully developed, and then you can compare it to what you're looking at on the paper as far as bad and good results. For this test strip, both of the test strips were the exact same colors, and they were both in a safe drinking range, so I was ready to move on to the next test. The next test strip tests for things like chlorine, hardness, pH, alkalinity, and I will say that my well water is sort of a harder water. We have a water softener installed, but I'm expecting it to still turn up a bit hard because it just is. So my well water strip is the one on the right-hand side. And as you can see, it's a little bit higher in pH and a little bit higher in alkalinity. And that makes total sense because I added special ion drops that were supposed to increase the alkalinity of my water. And that supposedly is going to preserve your emergency water supply longer so that it tastes fresh longer. So without the ion drops, supposedly your water supply stays tasting fresh for about 2 years. The ion drops can potentially increase the freshness up to 6 years, but we'll see in the taste test whether or not that holds up true. I also did a quick test on my water supply for nitrites and nitrates. Supposedly, if you have bad levels of those in your water, it could lead to health problems, but my water was fine. The test strips were exactly the same for both parts of the water. So let's skip ahead to 2 days later when I'm showing you the bacteria results. Okay, so it's 48 hours later, and we're going to take a look at the test strips inside of these bags and see if they have any of the signs of bacteria. So on the front of it, it shows you what a bacteria sign would be, and there'd be like little yellow dots you can see there on that purple testing strip. So I sped this up so it's not as boring. But as you can see, this is the emergency water supply test, and there is no bacteria in that water. And of course, my drinking water doesn't have bacteria either. So let's move on to the taste test portion. So it's 2 days later, and I threw out the water that I was testing with. So I'm going to pour some new water from the exact same container, and we're going to do the taste test. I just want to quickly show you that these containers and most of these emergency water storage containers or camping water storage containers come with a little spout that makes pouring easier. That it will flow better if you remove that little plug in the back. It just lets air into the container, but I didn't feel like messing with it. Just wanted to show you guys. So one of the main reasons that I have long-term water storage is because I live in a hurricane-prone area. I live in Houston, Texas. So I'm just going to show you quickly that whenever hurricanes are coming and I need to use my, we lose power and I need to use my emergency water, I have one container like this filled just for washing hands and maybe for food prep. But it's, the spout makes it so convenient and nice, and you don't have to use as much because it's coming out at a nice slower flow. And then the other container I would use as drinking water, cooking water, whatever we need safe water for. Here's a quick look at the ion drops that I use when I'm storing my water to raise the alkalinity. Again, these are the drops that say that they're going to make your water taste fresh for up to 4 years longer than it normally would. So I poured some of that water into a cup and I gave it a quick smell test to make sure it didn't smell funky or stale or weird, cardboardy. I think it smells cardboardy when water smells stale. The water smells completely normal. And when I taste it, I can taste that it's a little bit different than my normal drinking water, but I don't think it tastes bad. I lived in California for a couple of months. I lived in Florida for almost a year and a half. The water in both of those places is pretty gross. This water tastes just slightly different than my drinking water, but it's not bad. It might actually be the alkalinity drops that has changed the taste of the water just a little bit. But if your emergency water supply tastes a little strange, or you just don't really like the taste of water at all, you can always use flavored drink mixes. Some people say that you can add just a little bit of salt to your water and that'll improve the taste a lot. You can use a water filter like this Brita water filter to sort of freshen up the water a little bit. Boiling the water is always another option before you drink it, just so that you can get some oxygen back into that water and hopefully get the taste back to normal. You can also pour the water back and forth between two different cups to try to add the oxygen back into the water and get that taste back to the normal fresh taste that it always has. And don't forget, you can always do what the old timers did and use coffee crystals and tea bags to make your water taste better so that you can actually drink it. So now that we know that the water still tastes fresh 2 years and 2 months after I bottled it, you can go back and check my video if you want to see the steps that I followed to bottle this water. But I know that storing in plastic isn't ideal for some of you. I've had comments about some people suggesting stainless steel water storage and other people suggesting glass water storage. I think stainless steel would be great if it wasn't so expensive. Most people aren't going to be able to afford those large stainless steel containers. I am thinking about doing a glass water storage video, how to prep your water for storage in glass containers. If you'd like to see that, put it in the comments below. If you have any other things that you'd like me to test around here or show you how I do things related to water storage, prepping for emergencies like that, put them in the comments. I'd love to see it. I might make videos for other things that you guys want to see. All right, thanks for checking out this video and good luck with your water storage, guys.